Hi, everybody. So, Lydia and Ezra and I are here at home, and we brought a few special things along with us. More than a few. We have a lot of things here. And something that these things all have in common is that they're squishy. Squishy.
And I got this for Easter.
Yes, it came from an Easter basket, huh? And we have some little snugglies, and they all kind of, most of them sort of fit in your hand. Do you have anything like that at your, where you are? I mean, I'd love to see some pictures of those. Maybe you can share those. But we like to pull these things out, especially when we feel what?
Mad.
What else? When do you pull out your squishies?
Like, probably when someone was being mean to you.
When someone was being mean to you? Yeah. When you're upset, mad,
sad.
And sometimes
when mommy's mad at me, I sometimes like to snuggle with my Pokemon.
It helps, doesn't it? It helps. And sometimes I know Lydia grabs one of these things and likes to tell it what she's upset about. Do you have a special one you like to talk to?
I like to talk to mommy and daddy.
Yeah, that too. That's also good. Which is going to lead us into our next piece. But I wanted to bring all these guys and share them because we at our house are having some worries lately, and we don't know if maybe you are too. Feeling maybe a little worried, a little bit stressed. What are you feeling worried, stressed about?
Like virus.
Yes, that's still on our minds and our heads, and part of that is what school is going to be like this year. There's just so many worries in the world. We don't know what school's going to be like. It's going to be different than usual, that's for sure. No question that it will be different. And we'll get through it, and we'll be okay. And right now, we're just feeling a little worried and anxious about that. Yeah? Yeah.
Yeah.
And in the Bible, God tells us all the time not to worry. Not to worry. And I like a very special verse in Peter, where the writer of that book tells us to just give all your worries to God. Give all your worries to God. And that's what I kind of like to think of doing when I'm squeezing one of these guys. Just think that I'm just squeezing my worries all out and God's taking them. Yeah. And another way we can give our worries to God is, like Lydia said, to talk to someone we trust. And sometimes that is the biggest help. We can just get it off our chest and share our worries with somebody else. And then they don't feel so big anymore. They're still there. It doesn't make the problem go away always. No. But sometimes it feels better to just know that somebody is listening and that somebody can carry your worries with you. And that's what giving it to God is. It's sharing the worries. Because God gave us a whole big community of people who love us, people in the church, teachers, family members, Pastor Sally. There are lots of people who love you as brothers and sisters in Jesus and will listen. And for me, that makes a big difference. What do you think? Yeah, what do you think? Does it help to share your worries? Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's my challenge to you today, is to find something squishy that you can squeeze your worries into and to share your worries with God by maybe prayer, like we've been talking about all this time, or maybe by talking to someone who will simply listen and help share the load. Okay? All right. Let's pray, and if you want to use your squishy while you pray. That's fine.
This is how I want to hold my hand.
Sounds good. Like all right. This. Big deep breath. Dear God. We know that you will help us.
We know that you will help us.
To carry our worries.
To carry our worries.
Help us remember.
Help us remember.
To share them with you.
To share them with you.
By talking to the people who love us.
By talking to the people who love us.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. You guys have a great week, and we will talk to you next time.